Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. So listen up folks, there will be a second customer and partner roundtable for SAP BTP ABAP environment happening next week. Don't miss your chance to grab a seat at the roundtable and get information on the latest updates and learning materials for SAP BTP ABAP environment and get some of your questions answered by our expert development colleagues. Next week, you will have two chances to join the roundtable session, the first on June 13th from 9 to 10 a.m. Central European time. And then the second one is happening the next day on June 14th from 6 to 7 p.m. Central European time. For more information about this excellent opportunity, please check out Iwona's blog post today.
We are excited to announce that starting with OpenUI 5 and SAP UI 5 version 1.116, releasing in January 2023, the UI 5 framework libraries will adopt modern ECMAScript syntax and introduce specification version 3.0 in UI 5 tooling configuration. As a result, users of UI 5 tooling will be required to upgrade to version 3 and ensure their projects and development infrastructure fully supports this change. This update enables the usage of modern ECMAScript features up to ECMAScript 2022 and ensures compatibility between the framework libraries and the latest UI5 tooling version, providing a more robust developer experience. Be sure to check out the link below to learn more about this change and happy coding.
Heart rate 86 BPM. We at SAP teamed up with Jan Frodeno, a world championship triathlete, to give you a unique opportunity to analyze Jan's training data, actually not mine, the training data, Jan's, and complete missions to optimize his training for this year's Ironman World Championship. Together with Jan, we would like to invite you to plan to win Get Active with Data, a virtual hackathon. Your challenge, should you accept it, is to build an analytics tool for Jan Frodeno using SAP DataSphere or SAP Analytics Cloud. You may participate as a team or as an individual. This is a global program and participants from around the world are eligible to register. Upon registration, you will receive access to data from Jan's workouts with his explanation of each KPI presented there. If you do not feel confident with SAP DataSphere, no worries. There is an open SAP course called, yes, the Introduction to SAP DataSphere, happening right now. Join that free online course to learn about SAP DataSphere and explore how business users can leverage the data marketplace to explore data, integrate information, and share insights. Talking about open SAP courses, if on the other hand you are an experienced developer using SAP HANA database, then you might find interesting another course starting next week about using the optimizer for SQL script programming.
Hi everyone, and welcome to SAP Developer News. Some have referred to it as the hot dev summer. That's what's gonna happen in July in St. Andreas in Germany. We will have a 4-day stretch of fantastic SAP community events, all centering around UI5 and CAP, the Cloud Application Programming Model. We will kick things off on July 5th with a hackathon. We will try and build an adapter for Azure Cosmos DB to connect to the Cloud Application Programming Model. Then on July 6th, we will have UI5Con, the developer conference for all things UI5. The day after UI5Con, we will have Recap, the developer conference for all things CAP. And then on Saturday, on July 8th, you can get your hands on CAP yourself with an SAP Code Jam about CAP, together with my colleague DJ Adams. Some of the events are already booked out, but you can join the waitlist, but we do have slots available for some of the events too. So better check the blog post linked in the description. And I'll see you there. Bye.
Wow, what an incredible turnout for our May ABAP open source project. I've got to say, I'm honestly blown away by the creativity and spirits you've all shown. I can't thank you enough for making this challenge such a hit. It's been fantastic to see all the amazing projects you submitted. Your contribution has truly enriched our open source community, and for that, we're really grateful. But as they say, the show must go on. With one exciting challenge wrapping up, we're thrilled to introduce the next one. SAP UI5 Web Components for React. This month-long challenge promises to be as engaging and enlightening as the last. Here, you'll get the opportunity to construct a fully functioning table using a blend of SAP components and your own custom components. Now, to get started, head over to the blog post where we already laid out the details for week one of the SAP UI5 Web Components for React challenge. Remember, each week brings a new set of objectives, so do keep an eye out on the blog post for updates. Once again, I can't thank you enough for the energy, dedication, and passion you all showed in the ABAP Open Source Challenge. I have no doubt you'll bring the same excitement into the new challenge. So let's dive in, learn together, and most importantly, have fun.